God bless you. Today we are looking at the deep treasures of Ephesians together, and we'll be in Ephesians 1 verses 4 to 6 today. I'm excited to jump into this verse, these verses with you. Ephesians 1, 4 to 6 says, "For he chose us in him, who is Christ, before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and blameless before him. In love, he predestined us for adoption to himself as sons through Jesus Christ, according to the purpose of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace, with which he has blessed us in the beloved." So we're going to look at a couple of the original Greek forms of a couple of these words. But before we do, I want to just share with you some specific revelations that the Lord gave me as I read these verses. First of all, these verses speak to us as his people, as his children, that he is very specific. He is very intentional in his choosing of you as a son, as a daughter, that he wasn't careless about it. He wasn't last minute about it. In fact, it's quite the opposite. He chose you outside of time, outside of the creation of time, when God created the world and set time in motion. Outside of that place in eternity was when the Lord chose you. And I think it's important for us to understand, it's hard for us to understand the concept of eternity being outside of time, being something being eternal in its existence. But that is the way that he chose you. He chose you outside of time, before the creation of time. So you have always existed in his mind and in his choosing, in his intentional choosing. That is eternal. His choice of you and his intentional, determined decision to have you as his son, as his daughter, exists outside of time. So when you said yes to him, your decision to say yes to him, you are eternally his son, his daughter. And so it is an eternal existing point for you. And that's so important. Your place as his son or daughter, your place at his table, his feasting bridal table, transcends time. It is eternal. It always was and it always will be. That seat for you at the table, that adoption paper as legally belonging to him, is in the heavenly realms, in the spirit realms, eternal. It has always been and it always will be. And the way that we have this eternal place in him, this eternal sonship, this eternal seat at his table outside of time, is by the perfect shed blood of Jesus Christ. The blood of Jesus transcends time. Therefore, all that Jesus redeems, which is you and me, our redemption is eternal. It has always existed because his blood is eternal. And so there is no beginning nor end to your sonship, to your place in heaven at his table, to your being positioned beside him in the heavenly places. We have to, instead of using our mind, we have to step out of our mind and go into our spirit man, which is able to receive higher revelation, to understand spiritual realities, and say, "Lord, this verse tells me that I have belonged to you. You set your mind to pick me out, and I have belonged to you from in eternity. There is no beginning to that choice. There is no end to that choice. And my position in you is eternal. It's outside of time. I have always belonged to you and I always will in the eternal realm." Hallelujah. Why did he choose you? This verse says that he chose you to be set apart. That word holy, again, means to be set apart, to be different, to be consecrated. And this is mine. I'm setting this apart as mine, is what the Lord says about you. And that decision is to choose you is because he wants you to, as his, to belong to him. You came from him and he chose you to be in that place of being in him, to being set apart from all else unto Him. And this is a reality that there's layer upon layer of beauty and intimacy as we really consider what it means to be set apart unto the Lord, to be set apart into Him, not just unto Him, but into Him. You are set apart into the person of Jesus Christ as being one with Him, being one with Abba Father, being one with the Holy Spirit. And so you, that is why He chose you, not just to say, okay, you, yeah, you, yeah, you. No, He chose you to actually be in Him, be unto Him, to be set apart to Him, to be His. It's not about what you do for Him. It is about you being His and belonging to Him. And the doing at will flow, the gifts and the anointing will flow as you remain in that knowledge of being set apart to Him. Let's look at these words together. The first word I want to look at is the word chose. The verse said that He chose us in Him. This word in Greek is eklego. It means to pick out for a purpose, to pick out for a purpose. And it also means a highly deliberate choice with a definite outcome. The Lord says, I pick out for myself. And it's not for nothing. It's for a very specific purpose, which we just talked about, which is to be belong to the Lord, to be in Him, unto Him, to be in Christ. That is the purpose that He chose us. He picked you out. He eklegoed you. The word foundation, this action of Him choosing you happened before the foundation of the world. Foundation in the Greek is katabole, and it means down to the most specific detail, the most specific details of creation and the founding of the world. You were chosen before all of that. The divine plan of redemption, the divine plan that God had when He said, I can see out into eternity. I can see all things at once. He isn't limited to timeline and seeing just what's ahead. He saw all that would happen. And in that knowing, He knew that He would send His Son Jesus to come and redeem us back to Him, to be that redemption. And so that plan was established before the foundation of the world. Hallelujah. And so that redemption plan was sealed before you were created, before the world was created. Your being chosen, this word foundation shows us that your being chosen was established before the earth was formed. It is outside of time, this decision. It is in eternity. Therefore, it is an eternal decision. That speaks to the reality that your belonging to Lord, the Lord, your being chosen in Him is eternal. You have always had a place at Abba's table. It is an eternal seat because of the redemption plan, because of the blood of Jesus, which is eternal. And let's look at the word predestined. This is the Greek word proorizo, and it means to pre-establish, boundaries before creation, to foreordain, to separate, mark off, appoint, and determine beforehand. So the Lord, I want you to say this as a decree over yourself. If you are in the Lord Jesus Christ, you belong to Him, you can say with me, Lord, You separated me beforehand. You marked me off beforehand. You appointed me beforehand. You determined that I would be Yours beforehand. Before the creation of the world, You established me as Yours. The last word I want to look at is the word for adoption, because we learn in this verse that He predestined us, He established us for adoption, for belonging to Him. This is the Greek word huiothesia, and it means as a son into the divine family, to place as a son, to be legally made a son, which includes the word son here means son or daughter, to be legally bound into the family of God, to be legally a son, to be placed as a son into this family. And so I want you to receive that reality if you have said yes to the Lord Jesus, to see yourself seated at that table with the family of God, with a seat with your name on it that has been eternally yours. You have been eternally seated in that place, and it is outside of time. Therefore, the enemy can't steal it from you. It is yours, and you are in him, set apart unto the Lord and into the Lord himself. And I just want to bless you with these realities today in the name of Jesus.